As we saw, the energy of the universe is a constant. Therefore, if we have a reaction taking place in an apparatus called a bomb calorimeter, the heat given off by the reaction is absorbed by everything surrounding it. We can limit this to the calorimeter itself and the water contained within it. By monitoring the temperature change of the calorimeter and the water, and knowing their heat capacity and specific heats, one can calculate the heat absorbed by them. And as energy is conserved, the heat absorbed is equal to the heat released by the reaction. For the calorimeter and water, the entire process is endothermic and the value for the heat is positive. For the reaction, the absolute value of the heat is the same, but is now negative as the reaction was an exothermic process. At constant pressure, the change in enthalpy in a system is equal to the value of the heat. Enthalpy is thus an important thermodynamic function. However, nobody really cares about a system's absolute enthalpy. All that is really important are the changes. In a sense, it is very much like measuring altitude. We are therefore allowed to choose an arbitrary value for zero. Unlike altitude, where we set our zero to sea level, each element has a zero. This zero is the value of enthalpy of an element in its most pure and stable form. For all other forms of the element and all possible compounds, enthalpy is measured relative to this zero and called the enthalpy of formation. For example, the enthalpy of formation of common sugar, sucrose, C12H22O11, is measured relative to 12 moles of graphite, the most stable form of carbon, 11 moles of H2, the most stable form of hydrogen, and 5.5 moles of O2, the most stable form of oxygen. Many times we can measure these changes in the lab directly from the reaction. However, often this is impossible. When this happens, one can make use of Hess's law, which states that a series of reactions will have the same overall enthalpy change as the direct reaction. Simply put, for enthalpy changes and many other thermodynamic functions, it only matters where you start and where you finish. The path is not important. Finally, once we know the enthalpies of formation for each reactant and product in a reaction, the enthalpy of any reaction is but the difference between the enthalpies of formation of the products minus those of the reactants. The enthalpy of the reaction will provide us with the heat released if the reaction is carried out under constant pressure.